Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to simulate the motion of those annoying PowerPoint animations in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And if you've ever had someone who said, look, I'm going to continue to make PowerPoints, and we really need these animations to show up, go ahead, like, subscribe, tell me about it in the comments below. I am on a bit of a crusade to get pastors to quit using PowerPoint for sermon notes. Animations are not engaging, they're distracting. You've probably heard me say all that before. But I know that sometimes you can't do it. Well, if you have enough time, you can do this trick to kind of simulate it. It's a little more difficult than maybe you're used to, but it will do the trick. So let's head over to the computer, because this is going to be a little more involved of a tutorial. So here we are in ProPresenter, and this is actually not where we're going to do the bulk of our work. First off, this is PowerPoint, and this is the little example PowerPoint that I created. So let me just show it to you here. And see what happens with this area right here. Yep, looks like something Bill Gates would have done in introducing Windows 95, even though Windows 95 predates PowerPoint. And also this. Yes, very cheesy, not all that helpful. But if someone actually needs that, by the way, that is a true story. If someone actually needed to do that, how can you do that? Well, let me first escape out of this. And I'll tell you that. So this is the animation. I think that's the boomerang animation. And this one was like a spinner or something like that. Anyway, doesn't matter. That's what it is. It is what it is. So first thing I did is I went into File, Export. And when you do that, normally for ProPresenter stuff, you're going to want to export it as JPEGs or PNGs. That's fine. In this case, we're going to either choose MP4 or MOV. And I'm on a Mac. You might have slightly different options if you're on Windows. But we're going to want to export it as that. So that is thing number one. Now, let me quit out of that, because I need all the RAM I can get. Because, here, let me even quit out of ProPresenter. I'm going to actually fire up Final Cut Pro. And you can absolutely use Premiere Pro. You can use Final Cut Pro. You can use DaVinci Resolve. Any of those should be able to do this. So let's fire this up, and I'll show you what we're going to do. Pay no attention to the yellow background here while I'm doing this. Now, this is where I normally edit my videos. Actually, recently I've let someone else do that. But before that, this is where I would do it. So let me actually just first off start by creating a new project. So File, New. Let's call this I don't know. PowerPoint clips. So, and let me import that clip that I exported just a second ago. testppt.mov. Okay, just to show you, here it is in QuickTime, so you'll notice right there it comes in, then it goes to the next slide, and then that comes in, etc. So let's see if we can't find where that is located. I should have paid attention to that earlier. I know what I'll do. I'll just bring it up in Finder here. Right there. Okay, that's where it is. And that is in Teaching Media and Text. So that's under Downloads. There it is. Okay. And here's that video. Just to double check, we'll let that load here. Yep, that's it. Okay, so let's import selected. Okay, now what I want to do is, first off, I'm going to hide this transition. I'm going to bring this in, the whole thing into the timeline here. Let's bring up the preview here. Yep, there we go. That solves that. Okay. So now what I want to do is I want to start it right where it starts and then go to right before that comes in. So I'm going back one frame at a time. That's probably good here. And now I'm going to clip it. So what I'm going to do is for this first thing, it's going to start right here. And then as soon as that video plays, it plays that transition. And then I'll let that continue to play until right before it goes to the next slide, which is right there. So jump back one, two frames, and then I'm gonna clip it right there as well. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem. You can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here. And you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. And then should pretty quickly go to this, and then I'm going to stop it there, clipping it there. Okay, that's all we're going to deal with right there. So I've got these two little clips. And let me, actually, I'm going to make this into a compound clip. So that will do that one by itself. And I'm going to make this into a compound clip. So that'll do that one by itself. So now I can double click on this one and export just this. So file, share, export file. And none of this really matters all that much for this particular thing. Notice that this is a fairly small size, 120 megabytes, but let's check the settings. Yeah, see, it doesn't need to be ProRes. It can be H.264. Notice that when I change that, it changes to 8.1 megs, which is much better. So I'm going to go ahead and export that one. And let me put that in my folder where I know where it is. And now I'm going to go back and export the second one. And I'll show you why here in just a second. Double click on it so it's by itself. And file, share, export the default. Let's make sure that it's still set as H.264. It is. And the reason that I'm choosing that because the other one is better for editing. This is just going to be showing as a video. So I'm just going to click that. And I happen to know that ProPresenter likes H.264. So let's, both of those went there. Let's select this here. Okay, so, oops. So we've got this one, and now we've got this one. Okay, so let's bring those into ProPresenter. So let's fire up Pro7. Let me real quick fix this here. Okay, now let me show you what happens when I bring those in one right after another. I'm just going to bring them into this song here. So let's click down here from Finder on Windows, probably Windows Explorer. It's been a while since I've opened up Windows, so have to check that. And that did open up on a different screen, but I'm going to do that and then go to Teaching Media and Text where I had those. And I'm going to bring these both in. And I'm going to make them foregrounds because the entire point of each slide is these particular videos. So that is a foreground, but it's set to loop, so I'm going to right-click on it, set it to stop, and right-click on number two and set it to stop. Okay, and now, yep, That's exactly what I wanted. So let's just drag that there and drag that there. So now pay attention to what happens when I click on this one. It starts right here and then it brings that in. Now, one thing that I did incorrectly is if I go right click and go to inspector, I don't want this to fade to black. I want it to stay on the last frame. That's very important here. So let's go here. Actually, it is right here. Fade to clear is what I had it on. It needs to be hold last frame. So that should be correct now. And let's do the same thing here. Right click, go to inspector, and set it to hold last frame. Hold last frame. So now when I click on this and start it, plays through and then it stops. And that's the way that it stays until I click on the next one, which starts at the last couple of frames of this. And then when it does that, it transitions to the empty slide and brings in that full screen right there. So those two are the things that that it can do. Is basically you can, by clipping it strategically right before the transition starts, you can make it appear like you're using the transitions with ProPresenter when in fact these are all video files. And since each transition is its own video file and it stays up on the last frame, the pastor could continue to talk about it, you know, for as long as possible. Just keeping it up there, just like that, blah, 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 for as long as he wants to, and it acts like PowerPoint. Now, you can't fix any typos or anything like that, but that is a way around that problem. So that's one way to get around that in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address and I'll make a login for you for free. Till next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.